Welcome to the iHistory channel, where we delve into the intriguing annals of world history. Today, we're whisking you back to the heart of the Cold War, to a time of secrets, espionage, and technological marvels. Picture this, a Soviet submarine lying dormant at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean. Now imagine the audacious plan to recover it. This is the setting of our story today, the Azorian Project. The Azorian Project wasn't just any covert operation, it was a top-secret mission orchestrated by the United States, a mission so daring it seems ripped from the pages of a spy novel. Its goal, the recovery of a sunken Soviet submarine, an operation of such complexity and cost that it still captivates historians and enthusiasts alike. So buckle up for a journey into the depths of the Pacific, into the corridors of power where secrets are kept and revealed. Join us as we journey back to the height of the Cold War. In the depths of the Pacific Ocean in 1968, a Soviet submarine known as K-129 mysteriously sank. The Cold War was at its peak, and the world was a chessboard for the superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union. The K-129 wasn't just any ordinary piece on this chessboard, it was a well-armed, nuclear-capable Gulf II-class submarine, a significant player in the high-stakes game of global power. The K-129 was on a routine patrol, some 1,500 miles northwest of Hawaii, when it simply vanished without a trace. The Soviets launched an extensive search but found nothing. The submarine, along with all 58 of its crew, had seemingly disappeared into the abyss. But the US had a secret weapon in its arsenal, a worldwide network of hydrophone listening stations, part of a system known as SOSUS. It detected an underwater explosion in the area where K-129 had been patrolling. The US Navy conducted a search of its own and found the wreckage of K-129, resting nearly 3 miles beneath the ocean surface. The sinking of K-129 was more than a naval disaster for the Soviets, it was a potential goldmine of information for the Americans. The submarine was a treasure trove of military secrets, holding not just nuclear torpedoes, but cryptographic equipment and code books that could give the US invaluable insight into Soviet naval strategy. Moreover, the K-129 was also a technological marvel of its time, and recovering it could provide the US with a rare opportunity to study Soviet submarine technology, to understand their capabilities and weaknesses. The US was not just interested in the K-129, it was eager, hungry even, to get its hands on it. But the submarine lay in one of the deepest parts of the ocean, well beyond the reach of any existing technology. The challenge was formidable, but the potential rewards were too great to ignore. The US, sensing an opportunity, devised a daring plan to recover the submarine. Thus, in the shadows of secrecy, Project Azorian was born. In the cloak and dagger world of Cold War espionage, the United States had embarked on a mission of unprecedented scope and ambition. The objective was nothing less than the recovery of a sunken Soviet submarine from the abyssal depths of the Pacific Ocean. At the heart of this audacious endeavor was Project Azorian, a top-secret initiative conceived by the Central Intelligence Agency. This was no ordinary salvage operation. The submarine, codenamed K-129, had sunk in international waters, carrying with it a wealth of military secrets. The Americans saw an opportunity, a chance to gain an edge in the ongoing Cold War. The CIA spearheaded the project, but they were not alone in this undertaking. The task was so gargantuan that it necessitated the collaboration of various organizations. Among them was Global Marine, a company with expertise in deep-sea drilling. Their role was to design and construct a colossal ship, the Hughes Glomar Explorer, capable of carrying out the clandestine recovery operation. The Department of Defense was also deeply involved, providing logistical support and security for the operation. The project was so hush-hush that even within these organizations, only a select few were privy to its true purpose. The mission parameters were clear yet daunting. They had to locate the wreckage, which was lying more than 3 miles beneath the surface. Then they had to devise a method to hoist the submarine, weighing thousands of tons, onto the Glomar Explorer without attracting the attention of the Soviet Union or the international community. All this while working in an environment as inhospitable and unpredictable as the ocean's depths. The task was monumental, the stakes were high, and the clock was ticking. The birth of Project Azorian marked the beginning of one of the most ambitious and secretive operations in the history of espionage. What lay ahead was a journey filled with technological challenges, geopolitical intrigue, and the indomitable spirit of human endeavor. Under the guise of mining manganese nodules from the ocean floor, the CIA commissioned the construction of the Hughes Glomar Explorer. This ship was no ordinary vessel. It was designed with one singular purpose in mind: to retrieve the sunken Soviet submarine from the depths of the Pacific Ocean. The task was not as simple as it might sound. The submarine lay at a depth of over 3 miles, far beyond the reach of conventional diving or salvage operations. This was a realm of crushing pressures and perpetual darkness, a place where humans had never ventured before. To operate in such an environment required a level of engineering and technological innovation that had never been seen before. The Hughes Glomar Explorer was built in secrecy in the Philadelphia shipyards. It was a colossal structure, nearly 2 football fields in length and equipped with the most advanced technology of the era. Its most unique feature was a massive claw-like device known as Clementine, designed to grasp the submarine and lift it from the ocean floor. The ship set sail in the summer of 1974, heading towards the location of the sunken submarine. Its journey was not without incident. Soviet ships and aircraft were frequently spotted in the vicinity, raising concerns about the security of the mission. However, the crew of the Explorer managed to maintain their cover story, convincing the Soviets that they were merely mining for manganese nodules. As the Explorer reached its destination, the crew began the meticulous process of positioning the ship directly over the submarine. This was a task that required a level of precision that was unheard of in any previous salvage operation. The Explorer was equipped with dynamic positioning systems that used thrusters to keep it in place, counteracting the forces of wind, waves, and currents. With the ship in position, the next stage of the operation could begin, the descent of Clementine. This was a delicate and time-consuming process, with the claw-like device being slowly lowered into the depths of the ocean. The crew watched anxiously as Clementine disappeared into the darkness, not knowing if they would ever see it again. After several days of nerve-wracking suspense, Clementine finally reached the ocean floor and the retrieval of the submarine could begin. However, the submarine proved to be a challenging target. It was severely damaged and partially buried in sediment. The crew had to carefully maneuver Clementine to grasp the submarine without causing further damage. The lifting process was slow and fraught with difficulties. The submarine was far heavier than expected, and the strain was too much for Clementine. A portion of the submarine broke off and fell back to the ocean floor. Despite this setback, the crew managed to retrieve a significant portion of the submarine, including some of its most sensitive components. Once the recovered submarine was safely aboard the Explorer, the ship quickly set sail for home. The crew had accomplished a feat of engineering and endurance that was unprecedented in the annals of maritime history. They had ventured into the abyss and returned with a prize that had seemed unreachable. Despite numerous challenges, the mission was partially successful. The Azorian project had demonstrated the lengths to which nations would go in the pursuit of knowledge and power. It was a testament to human ingenuity and determination, a story of daring and deception in the depths of the ocean. The Azorian project, despite its partial success, had significant consequences. After the dust had settled and the mammoth ship, the Glomar Explorer, had returned to port, the ramifications began to unfold. The operation had been a high-stakes gamble from the onset, a daring endeavor that sought to push both technological and diplomatic boundaries. The United States had risked a great deal, both financially and politically, to salvage what remained of a sunken Soviet submarine. Despite the audacious nature of the mission, the yield was less than expected. The US had hoped to recover an entire Soviet Gulf II-class submarine, complete with its nuclear warheads and crypto equipment. However, during the lifting process, a significant portion of the submarine broke off and plunged back into the depths, taking with it much of the most desired intelligence. Yet, the operation was not entirely fruitless. The section that was recovered contained 2 nuclear torpedoes and important documents, offering valuable insights into Soviet naval technology. The political fallout was equally significant. The Soviet Union had been suspicious of the Glomar Explorer's activities, but had no concrete evidence to challenge the US until a journalist named Jack Anderson exposed the project in 1975. The revelation caused a diplomatic row, but the US managed to navigate the stormy waters without severe repercussions. The declassification of the Azorian project came much later, in 2010, when the CIA finally acknowledged its existence. The release of a heavily redacted 50-page document shed light on the operation's intricate planning and execution, a testament to the extraordinary lengths the US was willing to go to gain an edge in the Cold War. Yet the legacy of the Azorian project extends beyond the realms of politics and espionage. It was a feat of engineering and human endeavor, one that pushed the boundaries of what was deemed possible. The custom-built Glomar Explorer, with its innovative capture vehicle and sophisticated recovery system, set a new benchmark in marine technology. It marked a significant leap forward in deep-sea exploration and salvage operations, paving the way for future endeavors. However, the project's astronomical cost, estimated to be in the region of hundreds of millions of dollars, drew criticism. Many questioned whether the intelligence gathered was worth the expense, particularly given the partial recovery of the submarine. The debate over the project's cost-effectiveness continues to this day. The Azorian project remains one of the most audacious and costly covert operations in history. It stands as a symbol of the lengths nations will go to in the name of national security and technological advancement. Despite the controversy and the less than ideal outcome, the sheer audacity of the operation, its technological innovations, and its indelible mark on Cold War history ensure it will never be forgotten. The Azorian project was a testament to human ingenuity, courage, and the lengths nations will go to in the name of national security. In the grand tapestry of history, the Azorian project weaves a tale of audacious ambition and clandestine endeavors. At the height of the Cold War, the United States embarked on a mission that was no less than a feat of engineering marvel. The task was daunting, the stakes were high, and the world was none the wiser. The sunken Soviet submarine, lying more than 3 miles beneath the surface of the Pacific Ocean, became the unwilling participant in this high-stakes game of subterfuge. The birth of Project Azorian marked a turning point in the covert operations carried out by nations in the name of national security. This was not just about recovering a submarine, it was about gaining a vital edge in a world divided by ideological differences. The execution of the project was a testament to human determination and technical prowess. It was a dance of precision and patience, of careful planning and daring execution. The use of the Hughes Glomar Explorer, a ship that was a marvel of engineering in itself, demonstrated the remarkable lengths the United States was willing to go to achieve its objectives. The aftermath of the operation was marked by a mix of success and failure. While not all of the submarine could be recovered, the project achieved its primary objective, to prevent the technology and secrets onboard the submarine from falling into the wrong hands. The Azorian project, shrouded in secrecy for decades, serves as a poignant reminder of the lengths nations are willing to go to protect their interests. It's a chapter of history that underscores the complexity of international relations and the indomitable spirit of human endeavor. As we close this chapter, let's remember the Azorian project for what it was: a bold, audacious, and somewhat controversial testament to human ingenuity and the relentless pursuit of national security. Thank you for watching the video. Subscribe to the iHistory channel, like and share. Also, don't forget to activate the notification bell.